Welcome back to part 2 of this tutorial. In this video we are going to assemble the foundation of our project. We will create a predefined array of objects that will define our 3D world. But first, let's take a look at our reference. If you hover over an object in BrickBlock, you will notice that the whole world is made out of a lot of boxes. In this part of the tutorial, we will create an array of boxes that will define our world. The actual graphics will be created later and basically are just eye candy on top of those boxes. So, now we are back in Unity, and first I want to try to visualize what we will program later on. So basically we need an array of cubes. So I will just create a cube first, create another one, duplicate it, just to create our first layer of cubes. This could be the basement of our building. And then we have one layer of cubes. We will just create another layer, and another layer on top of this. To create a structure like this, we can use loops. So basically what we can do is create one loop that creates one row, another loop inside of this row that will create the columns, and we will have a third loop that will wrap around those rows and columns to create our layers. So we will have three, four loops with a specified range to create our building. So let's start by creating the foundation of our level through code. First, I would like to remove all of those objects here, because we don't need them. Next step would be to just create an empty game object and name it level generator. Place it exactly in the center of our scene and create a new script that we will simply call level generator. After the script has been created, we can simply assign it to our level generator object by dragging it onto it and by double clicking on the script we can open it with VS Code. Now that we are in VS Code, we can start developing our script. First, what we need is three parameters to define our world. The first one would be the width of our building. This would define the length of the columns and rows. So I will just make it 5, and the type will be integer. Then we will have another integer that defines the height of our building. Let's just do it with 10 units right now. Then we need some object to be instantiated to our function. For this, I will use a public game object and just call it grid element. Since our script only gets executed on the start, we can get rid of the update function. To create our world, we need three for loops. So I will just create the first for loop right now. For int y equals 0, y smaller than the height, y plus plus. Inside of this for loop, there will be a for loop the x coordinate and another for loop for the z coordinate. I'm using the y coordinate first because I want to build my level layer by layer, and the y coordinate is the coordinate that points up in Unity. For x and z, we need to change height to width. And basically that's it. We now have our for loop, or our loops, to create our level. So what we need to do now is we need to instantiate our grid element object. For this we can simply type instantiate, define the object we want to instantiate, in our case it's the grid element, define its position, which will be a new vector tree with x, y and z, and we need to define the rotation, which will be just quaternion identity to retain the orientation of the world or the parent object. What we need to do now is to create an object that gets instantiated, because currently we don't have any object assigned to our script. So back in Unity, I will just create a new game object. In our case, it will be a simple cube, and call it grid element. I will move this grid element into our asset browser to create a new prefab. So we can simply remove the grid element from our scene hierarchy. When we then assign our grid element here to the grid element game object in our level generator script and execute our code, we will have a huge pile of boxes with multiple layers. Let's zoom out a little bit. In the beginning I talked about that we are going to have an array of objects. Currently we just have a bunch of game objects in our scene hierarchy, but we don't have an array to store them. So next step would be to create an array inside of our level generator object to store our grid elements. Actually, currently we are creating just simple game objects, but what I want to do is create an array of grid elements. So we create a new class and call it grid element and assign our new class to our grid element object. To instantiate grid elements and not game objects, we need to change the type from our grid element to grid element. If we go back into Unity, we have to reassign our prefab object in our level generator because we broke the reference by changing the type. And now when we hit the play button, we are creating a bunch of grid elements, but still they are not assigned to any array. Now we are back in VS Code and let's create a new array of grid elements. Just type in public grid element array and call it grid elements. Now we have created our array, but we need to initialize it first. So in our start function, we type in grid elements equals grid element array. And the length of the array is defined by the width times the height. And don't forget the new to initialize a new grid element array. To assign our grid element to our grid elements array, I'm going to use a temporary where variable, just use the type grid element and call it grid element instance, and this equals the instantiated grid element. To assign it to our array, we just type grid elements and have to define the index, which would be x plus grid times z plus grid times y. And this equals our grid element instance. This code here is needed because we need to transform our three-dimensional array into a one-dimensional array. Later on, we can use the same code to access neighbor elements in our one-dimensional array. Okay, now we are back in Unity with our recently changed script. And if you now hit the play button, we are instantiating our modified prefab with the grid element component. And in our level generator object, we have an array of 250 grid elements. Everything works fine, we don't have any errors. Now I would like to clean things up a little bit because our whole project is starting to look a little bit messy. First, let's create some folders for our scripts and prefabs. Just create a first folder, call it scripts. And a second folder that we call prefabs. And we will move our prefab into the prefabs folder and our scripts into the scripts folder. The next thing I would like to change is the hierarchy of our level generator, because currently all of our grid elements are getting instantiated in the root of our scene, and that looks really, really messy. To change this, we go back into VS Code, and in the instantiate function, there's an overload to define the transform parent of the object. In our case, we just use this dot transform to parent our grid elements to the level generator. Another thing I would like to do is name our grid element instances. So we just type grid element instance dot name equals grid element underscore plus x plus y plus z. So we have uniquely named grid elements in our scene hierarchy. So now if we hit run in Unity, our grid elements are parented to our level generator object, and they are nicely named. Every object has a unique name, and we can easily identify them by just selecting them by the name. So now that we added all of our scripts, we can commit them to our repository. Just type in git status to check all our recent changes. And before we will commit our project changes, I would like to add the VS Code folder to our gitignore file. Just open it with VS Code and type in VS Code . Now we have a modified gitignore, which I will commit first. Edit VS Code to gitignore as the message. Then we can simply add all of our other files. And I just call it edit level generator and grid element. And now we are done. In the next video, we are going to create a 3D cursor that will be placed through a waycasting function. With this cursor, we will be able to activate and deactivate those cubes. If you have any questions, you can leave them in the comments below. See you in the next video.